أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Dear respected brothers, dear sisters, alhamdulillah, we just finished Salat al-Fajr al-Jama'ah. May Allah accept it from us all, inshallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Holy Quran, وَأَنَّ إِلَى رَبِّكَ الْمُنْتَهَى وَأَنَّ إِلَى رَبِّكَ الْمُنْتَهَى وَأَنَّهُ هُوَ أَضْحَكَ وَأَبْكَى وَأَنَّهُ هُوَ أَمَاتَ وَأَحْيَى وَأَنَّهُ خَلَقَ الزَّوْجَيْنِ الذَّكَرَ وَالْأُنْثَى من نطفة إذا تمنى وأن عليه النشأة الأخرى وأنه هو أغنى وأغنى وأنه هو رب الشعرى. These ayat from Surah Al-Najm. Let's see this ayah or this ayat showing us as Muslims that Allah Almighty subhanahu wa ta'ala alone has the full authority over everything. Subhanallah, over everything. Said to your Lord, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala almighty, the return and the end of all the affairs and everything, subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَإِلَيْهِ تُرْجَعُونَ ثُمَّ إِلَى رَبِّكُمْ تُرْجَعُونَ. Our return, all of us, back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You cannot escape from him. فَأَيْنَ تَذْهَبُونَ. Where are you going? From him to him. They have to understand that. And he has a control to make. Aywa, this is the main point today. This ayah, verse number 43. Allah Almighty has the control to make somebody happy and laugh. وَأَنَّهُ أَضْحَكَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has the control to make someone happy, contentment, and or content and laugh. And also has the control to make someone sad and weep. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has the control. We're going to go back to this ayah. And he has the control to give life to a being and to incur death. وَأَنَّهُ أَمَاتَ وَأَحْيَى. As he has a total control over life and death too. Not just to give it. He has a control over this life and death. Not just to give it to someone. That he creates the pairs, male and female. وَأَنَّهُ خَلَقَ الزَّوْجَيْنِ الذَّكَرَ وَالْأُنْثَى. From what? Drops of semen, male and female discharges. When it is discharged to the womb, upon him is another bringing forth on the day of resurrection. وَأَنَّ عَلَيْهِ النَّشْأَةَ الْأُخْرَى. He is the one who will bring us back. وَأَنَّ عَلَيْهِ. أَنَّ عَلَيْهِ. عَلَيْهِ. Look at the word in Arabic, subhanAllah. As if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala obligated himself to bring us back to the life. وَأَنَّ عَلَيْهِ. عَلَيْكَ بُكْرَ الْأَكْلِ يَا حَبِّ إِسْمَاعِيلَ. أنت عليك بكرة الأكل. يعني سبحان الله انت عليك بكره حق تجيب العصير وانت عليك بكره يبقى سبحان الله ازيف يو سبحان الله يعني الصين بالضبط اي فالله سبحانه وتعالى يسيد اي ام ذا وان غانا برينج يو باك نوبادي ايلس بيكوز نوبادي كان دو ذات اكسبت مي سبحانه وتعالى وان عليه النشأة الاخرى سبحانه وتعالى هي هوم جيفز ماتش اور ليتل اوف ويلث and contentment to which he wishes. وَأَنَّهُ أَغْنَى وَأَقْنَى. Let's go back to this ayah. وَأَنَّهُ أَضْحَكَ وَأَبْكَى. He is the one, he has the control to make you happy and laugh. سبحانه وتعالى. If somebody is laughing or the laughter in Islam, is it good or bad? رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم كان ضحكا بسامة. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, he used to laugh most of the time. He used to smile most of the time. But his laughter was smiling, صلى الله عليه وسلم. You see his face shining, mashallah, smiling without any sound. يعني like somebody, mashallah, like us, يعني سبحانه we laugh, all California, they are listening. رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم with a big smile, but you can, there is no sound, صلى الله عليه وسلم. كان ضحكه تبسما عليه الصلاة والسلام. And Allah سبحانه وتعالى, يعني he is the one, that's why he put it first, وأنه أضحك first. يبقى الضحك, being happy, to be happy, and smiling, this is something positive, not negative, something good in Islam. Some people, they love to live in what? In grief and sadness. Allah created them to be happy. He said, no, I don't like this. He never smile. He never talk about positive things. Whenever you talk to him, he's negative all the time. You see his face like 111 على طول كده he never 1111 he never smile يقول لك لو الدنيا if he laugh the rain is coming لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. Why? والله يعني احنا that's why be positive, smile all the time. رسول الله كان ضحكا بس mostly mostly, I can say 95% of Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم or more, he used to see the smile on his face. صلى الله عليه وسلم. Why? Because this is positive. Will bring positivity. Will make your body happy. Will make you good. Will make you healthy. You're going to think in the correct way. But if you will nag, you put yourself in a cage and say, this is Islam, I have to be sad all the time. Like this is not in Islam. This is from Shaitan. Who said? Allah. Allah said, Almighty in Surah Al-Mujadila, إِنَّمَا النَّجْوَى مِنَ اللَّهِ وَلَا مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ ليه؟ لِيَحْزُنَ الَّذِينَ أَمَنُوا. النجوى, the secret talks, it's always from Shaitan. Because Shaitan is coward. He's talking from far away. Secret, sending his messages to you. Whisper. From Shaitan, why? To make you sad. لِيَحْزُنَ To put you in grief and sadness. الَّذِينَ أَمَنُوا. For Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at the end, He has the control to make somebody happy and laugh and somebody sad and weep. وَأَنَّهُ أَضْحَكُ وَأَبْكَى. I will tell you, one time, Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم was sitting with Fatima, his daughter, and Aisha was there in the side. And he said, Fatima, come close to me. And they start telling her something. And Fatima رضي الله عنها, she start weeping and crying. And he looked at her face. Oh, my daughter is crying. What did they do? Rasul صلى الله عليه وسلم, come back. He called her again. Fatima, was telling her something. And she started smiling and laughing. She was so happy. And Aisha رضي الله عنها, she said, Fatima, come on. What did he tell you? عليه الصلاة والسلام. She said, ما كان لي أن أفشي سر رسول الله. I will not tell you the secret of رسول الله. صلى الله عليه وسلم. And later رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم one time, طبعاً when he died, that's before his death. He died, and after they finished his burial, Aisha was waiting, because this is رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم being buried in her room. So she was waiting, and she said, يا فاطمة كم, رسول الله died now. Tell me the secret, what did he tell you? He still remember. SubhanAllah. She said, yes, I can tell you right now. Who was صلى الله عليه وسلم first time was, telling me, I'm gonna die soon, ya Fatima. My death is coming soon, alayhi salatu wasalam. That's why I was sad and I started weeping, crying. And when he looked at my tears, he said, come back. What you're gonna be? Huh? The first from my family, al-huqan bi. You're gonna be the first of my family who die. After me. 6 months after the death of Rasulullah, Fatima died, radiallahu anha. Why Fatima was laughing? This is my شاهد بقى من الكلام كله عشان نستفيد بقى يلا خلينا نتعلم let us learn. Why Fatima رضي الله عنها was smiling? Huh? If I ask anyone of you, why? Because he's telling her you're gonna die and she was smiling. Why حج اسماعيل?
She was given that she will be with رسول صلى الله عليه وسلم in Jannah.
أيوه. Now, not yes, okay. Because the scholar they took from this hadith, from just that point, she was laughing and she was happy, that al-arwah, the spirits of the mu'mineen, they visit each other in Jannah. That's why she's going to see Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم from this point, let's learn. Al-arwah tatazawar fil Jannah. And I read another hadith, Fatima, she's going to hear that in Jannah. That's why he told her, you're going to be the first one from my family, and smile, be happy, going to come to me very soon. سبحان and that's why she was smiling. The scholar they take from this hadith, الأرواح, the أرواح المؤمنين, they are visiting each other in the hereafter. But is how? This is not my job, but your job, Allah's job. We believe. I believe that, inshallah, when you die, you're going to see your mom immediately. If you are in Jannah and she's in Jannah, you're going to be in the same side, both of you. You're going to see your mom, you're going to see your dad, you're going to see your grandparents, you're going to see all from your family, all of those who died, grandfather, mother, all of them. If you are in Jannah, I have a hadith, authentic hadith. When somebody is dying, Rasulullah صلى الله عليه وسلم saying, the amwat, the deceased, they are waiting for him. They are receiving him. I'm in party, يعني. No, the way they are receiving him. He's a new, like exactly, you're going from America to your country. Sheikh Ahmed is going to Sri Lanka. The rest of his family there, I'm sure. Oh, everybody's going, oh, Ahmed is coming from America. Oh, everybody's coming to the house to visit you. Same thing. You're going there to Dar al-Akhirah. But the way, Allah, he knows about that. فسبحانallah, you see, الأرواح, they are coming to receive him. And one of them, the people, الأرواح المؤمنين, they ask this guy, the new guy, is coming to them. How is my family in dunya? How is my son? How is my wife? How is my daughter? How is so and so? The hadith said that. Said, oh, he came before me. He died before me. He came to you. And one of them, he said, "Ugh, لقد ذهب إلى أمه الهوية." He's not with us. He went to the hellfire. If he died before you, it means he comes. He must be with us. But him, the man will say, "Ugh, لقد ذهب إلى أمه الهوية." He went to Jahannam. He's not with us. See, فأرواح المؤمنين there in inshallah. Since we die, that you're gonna see your dad, your mom, your parents, your family, those who when they're if they are in Jannah. Subhanallah. That's why Fatima radiallahu anha from this hadith, she was smiling, laughing because she's gonna see Rasulullah soon there. Sahaba like hadith Thawban and another Sahabi who was serving Rasulullah. Rasulullah, what's the matter? Why you cry? Why you weep? He said, "Ya Rasulullah, I can't wait to see your face when I go home to come to see your face. All the time, I love to be with you. I love to look at your face. In Jannah, when we go there, you're going to be in different level. How can I see you?" That's why he was starting crying. And they said, "Do you want to be with me in Jannah?" I said, "Yes." Said, "Aini ala nafsika bi kathrati sujood. Pray more. Prostrate more. You will be with me in Jannah." And athqal shay fi al-mizan, taqwa Allah. The most heavier thing in the mizan, in the scale. Taqwa Allah, the fear of Allah, and husnul khuluq. Good manners and good conduct. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is telling us in the hadith also, those who will be close to Rasulullah in Jannah, those who have good akhlaq and good manners. Yes. أَقْرَبَكُمْ مِنِّي مَجْلِسًا يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ أَحَسِنُكُمْ أَخْلَاقًا عليه الصلاة والسلام. For that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He is the one, He has full control in our life. He is the one, He can cause you, He can make you happy, He can make you laugh. I'm asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us all among those who are happy and smiling and laughing and positive people. And Ya رب العالمين, I'm asking Allah سبحانه وتعالى يا رب العالمين أن يفرحنا وإياكم في الدنيا والآخرة بلقائه وبطاعته قل بفضل الله وبرحمته فبذلك فليفرحوا وخير مما يجمعون. ربنا تقبل منا واغفر لنا وارحمنا واهدنا واسترنا واجبرنا. بارك لنا في هذا اليوم يا رب العالمين وفيما يأتي بعده يا أرحم الراحمين. بارك لنا فيه وفيما بعده يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم إنا نسألك يا رب العالمين أن تجنبنا الفتن ما ظهر منها وما بطن. اللهم ثبتنا وثقل موازيننا وحقق إيماننا وارفع درجتنا يا رب. نسألك العلى من الجنة, نسألك مجيبات رحمتك وعزائم مغفرتك, السلامة من كل إثم والغنيمة من كل بر والفوز بالجنة والنجاة من النار. اللهم نسألك الهدى والتقى والعفاف والغنى يا رب. ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. اللهم إنا على ذكرك وشكرك وحسن عبادتك, وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. جزاكم الله خيرا. نعم.